Hello lovelies, welcome to my channel. My name is Christiana and you are watching Christiana Flourishing. I want to welcome you all to this video or whatever you're going to watch now. I hope you watch it to the end, please. It's very important, and remember to give this video a thumbs up, yes, or whatever that helps us to take this video to another level. Thank you so much for your support to my subscribers and friends. I appreciate you all so much. May God bless you and my sharers. You all are amazing. I appreciate you. And if you're watching me, you're seeing me on your screen for the very first time, and you've not subscribed to my channel, what are you waiting for? Please help us. Click on the red button there, say subscribe, and put the bell on top. Yes, that whenever we upload videos, you will be notified and you don't miss anything. Thank you so much for your support. Please watch video to the end and leave your comment on the comment section so we can chat there. I want to see what you think about the video. Thank you and I love you. God bless you.
This is verse, no, the Passion translation of the Bible. The Passion. Lord, how wonderful you are. You have stored up so many good things for us. Like a treasure chest, heap up and spill it over with blessings. And for all for those who honor and worship you. So when you begin to worship the Lord, it's like God is storing blessings in the chest, in the treasure chest.
31 verse 19.
Everybody knows what you can do for those who turn and hide themselves in Him. Lift up your head before the Lord as you worship the Lord this moment. My Father. 14, verse 34. God teaches my hands to war, so that the bow of steel is broken by my hands. Thou hast also given me the shield of your salvation, and your right hand holding me up, and your gentleness has made me great. Thou hast enlarged my steps under me, and my feet did not sleep. I have pursued my enemies and have overtaken them. Did I die turn again till they were consumed? I want to read it to you from the Passion Translation, from verse 34. He said, you train me with the weapons of warfare. What is that? Worship is the weapon of warfare. As we begin to worship like this, things are happening. Many of us who don't worship, they pray a lot, but they don't worship. He said, you have trained him with the weapons of warfare. Worship is the weapon. Jehoshaphat put singers in front. They were going for war. Worship. You see the man of God now leading us on worship. Worship. Love was singers. I'm not singing praise songs. Pastor told us last November, which was the month of praise. His pastor said, praise is the most devastating weapon of a Christian. He says, you need to praise, the enemies are shattered. As I'm worshiping like this, as you join me with all of your heart to worship, before this time next week, there will be blessings of your blessings. Because this is the secret of the believer. Satan used it on Jesus. He said, if you worship me, I will give you the kingdom of the world, the wealth of the world, the glory of the world. He said, I will give everything to you. He said, all I want you to do is just worship. That immediately gives us the key. Worship is the key. So he said, you've trained me with the weapon of warfare. What is that? Worship. See, and then he says, my hands can bend a bow of bronze. You empower me for victory. I'll take that again. All glory to God. Your wrap around presence, your power within as I'm worshiping, makes me strong to subdue. And by stooping down in gentleness, you strengthen me and make me great. Jesus, you set me free from captivity. Now I am standing complete, ready to fight some more. Lift up your hands. More victory for you. I said, more victory for you. I said, more victory for you. Ecclesiastes 3, verse 13, King James Bible. Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 13. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh, holy God. Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 13, King James. And also that every man should eat and drink and enjoy the good of all his labor. It is the gift of God. Lift up your hand before the Lord. Say, I will enjoy the good of my labor. Say, I will enjoy my business. I will enjoy my job. Say, it is the gift of God. Hallelujah. Verse 14. I know. That whatsoever God doeth, it shall be forever. Nothing can be put to it. anything, take it from it. And God doeth it. That men should fear before him. Shout to me, hallelujah. Let's read it again. Verse 13 from the message. Message, verse 13. That is it. Tell people, that is it. Eat, drink, and make the most of your job. It is God's gift. Hallelujah. But I want to see verse 13. I have also concluded, Solomon is talking, the richest king that ever lived. I have also concluded that whatsoever God does, that is the way it's going to be. Always. God has announced abundance of grace for you and the gift of righteousness for you. That is the way it will always be. No addition, no subtraction. God's done it. That is it. Now I want to see the last part. This is what I want to see. And God has done that so we will quit asking questions. Stop asking questions. Where will the money come from? Stop asking questions. Where will the business come from? Stop asking questions. Where will the husband come from? Stop asking questions. Where will the child come from? Stop asking questions. Where will the help come from? Tell them to say, stop asking questions.